Hey everybody, how's it going? Welcome back to another MAMG Let's Play of Root Double. When we left off, Kazumi got hurt, and I felt super bad, but I think she's gonna pull through. I think she's gonna make it. Also, apparently, she's got a little bit of a relationship history going on, which is awesome and adorable, and I'm curious to see where that goes. But anyways, we need to focus on what's going on right now, which is, you know, explosions and bad times all around. Watase headed for the stairwell first after he parted with Kazumi. His goal was to find what had caused that explosion earlier. However, there's nothing here. He searched the stairwell as much as he could, but there didn't appear to be anything explosive in there. The fire extinguisher had sent shivers down his spine when he'd seen it earlier for some reason, so he checked it out. But it had already been smashed up into pieces, none of which held any clues. Besides, why would a fire cause an extinguisher to blow up anyway? Maybe there was a gas leak or something? But without his knowledge of fire investigations, Watase didn't know any more than that. It's bugging me, but I don't have enough time for this. He decided to give up for the time being and continue searching elsewhere. Area 2, Inner Ring, B2. Watase immediately began his search of the block. Only Kazumi and Jun had searched the place the first time through. This was also where their makeshift base was set up. It had been ages since anyone had last checked the area out. There's also enough room to believe that the survivors are constantly on the move. Watase quickly carried out his search with those thoughts in mind. But a nameplate labeling one of the rooms caught Watase's eye. Reference room. A room he'd never visited before. Could there be a hint about an escape route in here? Ukita had just warned him not to go poking his nose in too deeply, but this wasn't the kind of situation that allowed him to heed that warning. Good on you! Watase headed into the room with that thought in mind. It was a small room of about 5 meters in width. That entire space was almost completely filled with steel bookshelf upon steel bookshelf. There was a switch attached to each shelf, meaning it was most likely a movable type of bookcase. Yuri's not here, huh? Once he confirmed that, Watase's eyes locked into the bookshelf. A crammed line of books and essays were sitting there. An introduction to the informal field theory. Okay, informal field theory? Author Miyoko Tenkawa. Elementary Particles, Information and Consciousness. Author Miyoko Tenkawa. ESP Synchronization Hypothesis, author Antoine Corbet, translator Miyoko Tenkawa. Oh, so she's bilingual, at least. Cerebrum, Labyrinth of Physiology, author Ryoken Kashiwagi. Unbinding from Pseudoscience, the Future and Prospects of Parapsychology, author Koki Sumida. Before Crime, After Days, isn't that what we're playing? Author Chikage Sonomura, is that the author of the game? Particles, the Mind, and the Brain, author Shuya Eriguchi. Watase looked at all of their titles. I don't get them. Watase had no knowledge of science in his current state, so he didn't have the slightest clue what they contained. Now that he thought about it, the two main themes researched at the facility were nuclear power and biology. Either way, all he knew was that there's a lot of biology-related books in there. But there was a familiar name amongst all the authors listed. Miyoko Tenkawa. If his memory served him right, that was the name of Natsuhiko Tenkawa's mother. And when he saw those books, a strange anxiety welled up in Watase's chest. Watase was puzzled. Why would looking at books make him feel anxious? I know this isn't the time to be doing this, but Watase couldn't go against his feelings, so he took one of the books and flipped through it. An Introduction to the Informational Field Theory. This sounds very like 999. I don't want to say too much, but it just, you know, in my head, that's how it feels. In modern physics, all phenomena that shape the natural world can be explained with four fundamental forces. But there are phenomena such as the accelerating universe and so on that cannot be explained by those fundamental forces alone. It has become clear from recent high-precision observation that the rate at which the universe expands accelerates with time. It is from that survey that the theory of unknown energy, known as dark energy, repulsive gravity, was born. But if dark energy was supposedly does supposedly exist, then what is it? Various conjectures have been conceived, but they are all merely speculation. Thus, I continued to look into that force from the perspective of an elementary particle physicist, and formulated a hypothesis. Could it be information? If a fifth fundamental force does indeed exist, there's a high possibility that it is in fact information. I use a numerical formula to express the equivalence of information volume and energy. Then, after deriving its value, I discovered that said value completely matched up with the rate of universal expansion. In other words... Huh? Watase had no clue what he was reading. Yeah, I read it and I don't know what I was saying. Fifth fundamental force? Information? Dark energy? The hell's all that? He still had no clue why he felt such an intense anxiety from this book. Was it just my imagination? Watase wondered that as he flipped through the pages and kept reading. The following conjecture is based off of this theory. Even if information itself can exist independently and possibly interact, be conveyed, without the use of other forces as an intermediary. For example, since a human's thoughts are a type of information, they can communicate with others without the need for those thoughts to be converted into another medium, such as electrical signals. This is a somewhat extreme expression I'm using here, but this is the gist of the informational field hypothesis. The informational field is the place where information operates as the fifth fundamental force slash energy. If we are to consider this by using the human brain as an example, the informational field generated from thought information may in fact be what we call consciousness. It's still unclear as of this point as to what the process that creates the consciousness entails. I didn't realize I was going to be reading textbooks today. All we do know is that a consciousness is generated inside the brain when countless memories equal fragments of information, and electric signals running through the synapses interact. However, another conjecture can also be formed when you think on the basis of this hypothesis. If information can exist independently, then that means consciousness does not necessarily have to form in a brain. If a fixed amount of information gathers in one spot and interacts with each other, a consciousness can be born right then and there. Furthermore, if that information can be controlled, then it is also possible to artificially create a consciousness. Yeah, this isn't making any sense to me. What kind of research did Miyoko Tenko a person do? She'd called herself an elementary particle physicist, but he got the impression this research had more to do with biology. But to create a consciousness, why would anyone want to do that? What does research involving creating a consciousness have to do with nuclear power and biology? He wasn't sure why, but he felt a faint, ominous sensation. Despite that, he continued to read more of the book, oh no, and then gasped. In conclusion, the various theories laid out in the informational field hypothesis have yet to be proven, but this thesis has been repraised in a form I never once expected. This is all due to a rapid yet drastic change that has recently swept society. That change is the manifestation of BC.
BC?
Come to think of it, Anna had mentioned it before. She'd said that it wasn't all that rare for people who could use telepathy these days. Watase continued to read. The ability known as BC has been widely acknowledged by society in the last few years. It can be said that this has resulted in mindsets towards the nature of information and ways of communication to undergo tremendous changes. We also have discovered countless people who possess this ability that never would have conceived as feasible mere years ago. The abilities of BC can generally be classified into two groups. The first one is telepathy, the ability to directly send your voice into another's mind. We've seen that happen. The other is empathy, the ability to read the voice of another's mind. By describing these abilities with extremely coherent terms, we can explain them separately. When BC is used, the user's thought information is not converted into another medium. They communicate with their target by sending that thought information directly into the target's brain by using elementary particles as an intermediary. This matches up with what I proposed in my informational field hypothesis. Two completely unrelated fields of study, parapsychology and elementary particle physics, are connected by BC. Furthermore, while telepathy practitioners are still few, empathy practitioners are even rarer. But the true number of users isn't what's important here. It's the fact that an ability such as empathy exists. There's also the fact that the existence of information, known as the voice of the mind, can be observed by others despite previously being unknown to those other than the thinkers themselves. This is indeed the first and biggest paradigm shift of the 21st century. What? The words laid out before him were almost unbelievable. He'd already heard about the ability to directly send one's voice to another's mind. The problem was the other ability. He then remembered what Anna had told him earlier. I see. So when she said mutually communicate, she didn't just mean sending your thoughts, but also reading other people's thoughts too. Then the stuff in this book isn't just some pipe dream. Wadase looked at the bookshelf in shock to find that many of them had the phrase BC in the titles. Apparently, it was really considered a completely normal thing. Though there were very few of them, there were indeed people out there who could read others' minds. Just then, Watase finally realized the truth behind his anxiety. I see. So I was scared of this empathy ability. He didn't know exactly why. Maybe he had a really frightening experience with it before he lost his memories. But even if that weren't the case, he didn't feel like there'd be a possibility, there could possibly be anyone who was okay with having their mind read by someone else. No, what if, at this very moment, someone's reading my mind and can hear my fear of having my mind read? Watase's body shook violently in the face of that abrupt thought. If he were to trust what Jun said, then that probably meant none of the adults in the group were communicators. But what about the children? Could Natsuhiko read minds? Mashiro? Saryu? And what about Yuri? Teach said that Natsuhiko and his friends could use telepathy. Then isn't it naturally possible that they could use empathy too? Now that he thought about it, several suspicious events had occurred. Why had Yuri run away from the group? Why had Saryu fled from the group back then? Why hadn't they found the three survivors yet? Oh, I was thinking they could read their minds and they can avoid them. I see what you're thinking. Oh god, I can see what he's thinking. If those kids can read people's minds, and when you take into account they've been running from us, then maybe one of us hates them and they know it. He didn't want to believe it, but it all added up. If that were the case, then who was the one who hated them? It wasn't Watase at the very least. He knew that better than anyone. So it has to be one of the other four. Once he thought that, every single one of them quickly seemed suspicious in his mind. His anxiety swelled up like a balloon, and his heart started racing faster and faster. Doubt begot more doubt, but then it soon came full circle. No, wait, maybe it's the other way around. What if they're the ones who hate us? Those kids who could read people's minds were filled with malice and trying to back Watase's group into a corner for some reason. Maybe that was just an absurd theory, but if it's true, then can we fight off guys like that? As soon as he thought that... Uh-oh. A sudden headache ripped through Watase's skull, causing him to groan. His consciousness started fading as he grew incredibly dizzy. This is bad. Watase staggered his way out of the reference room as quickly as possible. Watase hurried into a nearby restroom where he'd once left the reference room. Oh, I didn't realize he's got a little scraggliness going on. He turned the sink faucet on with all his might and washed his face with cold water. But his headache didn't get any better at all. Not another headache. Wait, could this be the effect of radiation damage? It was at that moment that he remembered something Kazame and the others had told him. There's a possibility the tap water's been contaminated by radiation. That's right! You could get internal radiation exposure from just drinking it. No. He'd been washing his face with that stuff. Watase frantically wiped his face to make sure none of the water got in his mouth or nose. But his headache still hurt just as much as it had before, and soon he was assaulted with anxiety and fear that made him feel even worse. I mean, that's a completely normal reaction, right? Like, oh no, the thing I did to make myself feel better may cause me to die. Watase vomited into the sink. His stomach was empty, so all that came out were gastric juices. A heavy sense of fatigue weighed down his whole body. Starting to think about way too much at once, Watase gritted his teeth. Being trapped in this hellish environment was bad enough, but now strange incidents were happening one after another. People had either died or been killed, and on top of that, there might be monsters out there who can read people's minds. Watase was extremely confused. At that moment, countless disconnected images flashed through his mind as if they were conspiring with that confusion. What? I don't think this is gonna happen, because I feel like the beginning events of the game were so sudden and rapid, but I would love if he's actually been with both groups. Like, he was with the kids, and then he fell and lost his memory, and now he's with the adults. That would be amazing, but again, I don't think that's the case. What was all that? It felt like there had been images he didn't recognize mixed in with that one of Yuri. And that Natsuhiko Tenkawa and his friends, the very same people they were looking for now, had been in them. Why? Have I seen them somewhere before? He didn't know. He couldn't tell if they were his own memories or not. But as Watase was driven to the brink of confusion by those mysterious images, somebody in my head. It was the first time in ages he'd heard that auditory hallucination. Watase was overcome with astonishment when he heard it. Wait, could this auditory hallucination be trying to control me? That suspicion expanded into immense proportions in one quick moment. No, what if someone's been controlling me this whole time? Then who is the me that I've thought I was me up until now? Watase looked at his face in the mirror as he was seized by that primitive fear. That was my initial theory, right? That he's being controlled by somebody else. He's not actually Watase in that body. But I don't know anymore. Reflected in there was the face of an unfamiliar man he didn't recall. Watase felt whatever had been keeping himself sane up until that point start to fall apart in an instant. Kazami, Jun, Ena, and Ukita. Adults who possibly held some sort of malice against the survivors. Yuri, Saryu, Natsuhiko, and Mashiro. Children who possibly wielded a mysterious power. And himself, a man with vague memories and a will that might not even be his own. Just as Watase started harboring doubts toward everyone, himself included,
What?
Watase blinked. It felt like someone else's face was in the mirror. But all he saw there was his own face. What was that? Who was that? Perhaps it was a type of audio-visual hallucination, or maybe a flashback. He wasn't sure, but when he saw that face, he'd felt a mysterious sense of nostalgia come over him. His heart calmed for some reason when he muttered that. Watase felt as though that illusion had been admonishing him. That's right. I have to trust everyone and myself. Watase turned off the still running faucet. Looks like I was just jumping at shadows for a minute there. Watase finally realized that he'd regained his composure. and that his headache was now gone. By the time he left the bathroom, the doubts that had taken hold of him had completely vanished. I don't know if that's a good thing or not. Wantus had quickly checked his watch when he left the bathroom. The time was exactly 1:16 p.m. It's right about that time to take some more AD, huh? Wantus had administered himself with one of the ampules he had on him. The road ahead was still long. To make things worse, he was so tired that his body felt like lead at this point. Now that he thought about it, Watase realized he'd only accumulated 4 hours worth of memory since he woke up. In other words, 5 hours was longer than the life Watase could remember so far. Watase walked down the hallway as he felt frustration towards the whole situation, then suddenly heard an unfamiliar voice. What? The voice appeared to be coming from just past the corner in the hallway right up ahead. He then heard yet another voice echoing. Anna! It appeared to be Anna's. Who's Teach talking to? He could tell from the voice that it probably wasn't Jun or Kazami. Watase peeked around the corner to see what was going on. Is it that? Only to find Saryu standing in front of Anna. Watase immediately held his breath and listened in on their conversation.
それはこっちのセリフ。エナこそなぜここにいるの？昨日は私たちの情報に耳を貸さなかったのに。
She calls her teacher Anna, just straight, no formality, no sensei, no missus, no ma'am, just Anna. That's weird, especially in Japanese.
それはあの時も言ったでしょ。ここから先は大人の仕事だって。
I'm gonna trust her so I don't hop into this argument, is what I'm thinking it's gonna happen. Okay. What are they talking about? It didn't sound like Saryu was talking to Anna the way a student would to a teacher, told you. And the details of their conversation felt private. Watase almost walked out into the open on instinct, but he stopped himself at the last moment. He remembered how Saryu had abruptly ran away from him last time. Exactly. For now, I should trust Teach and watch how things play out. Anna then resumed the conversation.
いや。どうして?ましろがエナは心を開いていないと言っていた。私はましろの判断を信じる。
Also, sorry, I'm drinking some green tea, in case you're wondering what I'm sipping out of my cup. Because 2-hour-long episodes kind of dry your throat out.
え、鳥羽さんと一緒にいるの?あの子はどこに?
Of course, right now, having a scratchy throat just means total chaos, right? So, I'm trying to take care of myself.
今はいない。どういうこと?
Saryu didn't answer. Anna soon started to grow impatient.
心を開いていないことについて認めるわ。そうしなければならない事情があるのよ。
I'm really curious what they're talking about.
でも私はあなたたちの味方よ。信じてくれないの?
Saryu paused for what felt like forever, then spoke as if she'd made up her mind.
エナ、夏彦に免じて、一つだけ忠告してあげる。Okay. あの隊長という男には気をつけて。
Hey, that's me!
Eh?
Just then...
Oi! それはどういう意味だ?
Watase instinctively rushed out from behind the corner. Saryu turned herself aside and started running off at that exact same moment.
Matchなさい、サノミヤさん!
He shouldn't have darted out. Anna immediately gave chase. Dang. But Saryu pushed her away a second later. Watase caught Anna before she hit the ground. Saryu took the opportunity to run into the connecting passageway that led to the outer ring. And disappeared behind the security gate.
待ってくれ!
Watase quickly picked up the pursuit, but then the security gate shut before his eyes. Frustrated, Anna punched the closed gate. Watase quickly took out his card and opened the gate again. But Saryu was already long gone by then. Watase and Anna ran into B2 of Area 2's outer ring in pursuit of Saryu. But she wasn't anywhere to be seen.
Anoko, doko e?
Sagaso! Doko ga chikaku no heya ni kakurete iru kanousei ga takai.
Watase and Anna nodded at each other and then searched the nearby rooms. Watase couldn't help but voice his thoughts as he kept opening random doors.
Shikashi, Anoko, ore ga kiken tte, douyu koto nan da?
Sonna koto itte da wa ne. Daichou-san, sakki no hanashi ni kokoro atari wa?
Nope, I have amnesia.
Zannen nagara, nai.
So, demo, Sannomiya-san to Daichou-san no aida ni 何かがあったのは確かなはずよ。おそらく隊長さんが記憶喪失になる前に。ああ、俺も同じことを考えていた。だが俺はレスキュー隊員なんだぞ。それなのに彼女に何をしたって言うんだ。私に聞かれても分かるわけないでしょ。もしかすると三宮さんが何か誤解をしているのかもしれないけど。
Watase then remembered the wound on Saryu's arm as she said that. I wasn't the one who gave her that wound, was I? He couldn't think of any reason why he'd ever do that. The pair finished their search of the floor as Watase pondered that. Saryu was still completely nowhere to be found.
Sensei,
彼女を追いかけよう。彼女を見つけられれば直接いろいろ話も聞ける。待って、その前に。
Did you take AD?
隊長さんはどうして単独行動をしているの? 危険だから極力避けようって話だったわよね。
ああ、それは立花が。
Watase then explained to Anna how Kazumi had gotten hurt. While they were at it, Watase and Anna synchronized their PDA's map data to share each results, or share search results. There we go.
そっちではそんなことがあったのね。
Yeah, I don't know where Ukita's at though. He's gone. I really don't care though.
そっちではってこと。こっちもモリベさんが第6エリアの捜索中。Oh no!
My friends! They're getting hurt!
そうか。
Watase breathed a sigh of relief, but Anna frowned.
でも…
Yeah, definitely. Both Kazumi and Jun had been wounded in the same hour. It stunk too much to be a coincidence. It feels like there's an invisible enemy that's attacking us. But aimlessly fanning the flames of his anxiety wouldn't help a thing. He decided to focus on the pressing issue at hand first.
But first, Sensei, let's kill Saryu. まだ近くにいるかもしれない。ええ。
Anna nodded nervously, then broke off into a run with Watase. Watase and Anna were currently in Area 2's outer ring. Taking into account the state of things, Saryu had been the one to had to either run to Area 1 or in the direction of Area 3. But they didn't know which way she'd gone.
仕方ないわ。ここは二手に分かれましょう。
Okay.
ダメだ。
Okay, never mind.
いろんなことが起きてる以上、もう単独行動を取るのは危険だ。じゃあどうすれば?
Just as Anna said that, she and Watase heard a sound coming from afar off.
今の音は?
あっちだ。行こう、先生!
Watase and Anna ran towards the source of the sound, Area 1. On their way, they heard yet another noise.
間違いない。今度は連絡通路からだ。
The two of them followed the sound as quickly as they could. I'm gonna say it's Yuri. They ran through the connecting passageway and entered Area 1.
Daichou-san, kore!
Why is there blood? Only to see red blood stains scattered here and there. It's fresh, Is it Saryu's blood? The blood trail continued all the way to the stairwell. Wata-sei and Enna ran into the stairwell. The emergency staircase was collapsed as it had been earlier, leaving only a room full of debris. But Saryu wasn't there. And at the end of the scattered blood trail was a vinyl bag full of red liquid. The bag's label read AB. Okay. Wata-sei and Enna stood there in confusion. Oh god! Only for the fire door behind them to shut a second later. Taken aback with surprise, Wata-sei tried to open the door. But he couldn't. It only budged a few millimeters, like something was propped up against him. Yeah, we're about to die. Wata-sei looked around for an exit as he tried to recover from the shock. He quickly spotted something that caught his eye immediately. Oh no! Something was lying in the corner of the stairwell, a fire extinguisher. Yeah, you remember that story I told you about Kasasagi? Wata-sei suddenly realized something. Was the object that caught fire and exploded in the stairwell earlier the fire extinguisher? Wata-sei gently walked over to the extinguisher. He picked it up and examined it. I don't think you should be holding it up to your face, to be 100% honest. He turned it upside down and checked it out, only to find what appeared to be soldering marks on the bottom. Wata-sei picked up a piece of the debris. He pushed it against the soldering marks and tried to open up the extinguisher. He succeeded in removing the bottom of the extinguisher and found something strange inside. Oh, it's just a straight up bomb! Wata-sei gasped when he saw it. A cord stuck out of what appeared to be a digital clock, wrapped around several cylindrical objects. He could tell from a glance that it was a time bomb. Just as Wata-sei finished voicing his shock, oh god, we have a minute! Numbers appeared on the digital display. A strange beeping sound began echoing through the stairwell. Yeah, that's typically not a good thing. We're not playing golf! Wata-sei knew for sure that the constant beeps coming from the timer were a countdown to their deaths. Was this the one who, was this what the one who trapped us in here was after? Oh god, what are we gonna do? The staircase had crumbled and the fire door was shut. It was just as Enna said, there was no way out. The bomb's timer was ticking down by the second. And then, the time between the beeps gradually grew shorter and shorter, as if to fuel Wata-sei and Enna's fear. Wata-sei body slammed the door out of desperation. But it didn't budge an inch. Is this it? Is this where it ends? But just as Wata-sei was about to give up, what? Enna shouted that and took something out from under her clothes. That object, shining with black luster, was none other than a pistol? Enna pulled the trigger that was a wave of sheer disbelief hit Wata-sei. Why would you shoot a bomb? I'm just wondering, why would you want to do that? The bullet, okay. I was like, you trying to kill us faster? The bullet successfully destroyed the door's hinges. That makes way more sense. What do you teach, Enna? Though Wata-sei was still confused, he kicked the fire door with all his might. The door collapsed into the hallway, allowing light on the other side to shine in. Gonna save, because we might die. Yeah, I trust her, that's fine, I'll leave that. Yeah, definitely. Watase and Anna rush into the hallway without a moment's delay. They fled down the hallway as fast as they could, pursued by the sound of beeping from the room they'd escaped. It's gonna blow! Watase dove towards Anna as that realization hit him.
Sensei, stay off!
Watase threw himself into the hallway in order to shield her with his body. And then, the beeping finally stopped. Oh, thank God. Well, that's a relief. What? Over 10 seconds had passed since the beeping had stopped. But the only sound that filled the block was Watase and Anna's panting. Okay. Never mind. Sorry about that, everybody. The two of them got off the floor and timidly took a peek into the stairwell. However, no explosion had happened. I don't know. Also, like the ticking time bomb thing, I know that like that doesn't happen in real life. I say that like I have experience, but like obviously, a lot of times, bomb defusal experts, timers are worse because they could be a false time. It could say you have 30 seconds left when you only have 10 or none or an hour. So like they can't rely on that. So it'd be interesting if it like kept ticking after and like exploded later on. True, there had been several bizarre factors so far, like the sprinkler system being offline, or the passageway blocked by the electric cable and puddle, or the cargo lift being broken. But unlike all of those, there had been a clear malice behind this incident. But this was a bit of a sloppy job, wasn't it? Watase looked at the kicked down fire door. There was something that appeared to be a metal bar lying next to it. That must have been what had been holding back the door. It felt very improvised on the spot for a trap. And on top of that, the bomb in question hadn't detonated. If the one who had set up the whole thing had been trying to kill Watase and Anna, then they failed completely. Was there some reason they didn't spend much time on prepping it? Watase's thoughts were suddenly interrupted by the sound of footsteps approaching. It's Ukita! Oh no, it's Jun. He turned around to find Jun running towards him. Are you okay? Poor Jun. Another set of footsteps closed in as Jun said that. They looked up to see Ukita running their way. No, we're missing the most important one. Jun and Ukita had both said more or less the exact same thing. Come to think of it. Watase looked at Anna's hands in surprise. Ukita and Jun did the same, then gasped.
Tsubakiyama-san?
Kenju? Sore, doushitano?
Okay, in Japan, nobody has a gun. Like, it is very rare unless you're a police officer. And even then, it's rare. It's just a hobby of mine, I just like collecting weapons. Anna's body froze, and then she took a step back.
Sensei, saki sono ju, futokoro kara dashite wa. Douyu koto da ne? Doushite kimi ga sonna mono o motte iru no ka ne?
Sou da yo! Anta, kyoushi ja nakatta no?
I mean, she could be a teacher of firearms.
Chotto matte, minna gokai shite iru wa. Kono kenju wa, watashi no mochimono nanka ja nai no. Kono labo de hirotta mono yo.
Okay, that makes sense.
Hirotta? Doko de?
Oh, where the girl was. Okay. I trust her. Yep, I trust her. I don't think she's bad. I might die because of it, but I don't think she's bad. Anna cringed at Ukita and Jun's harsh glares. Watase thought over the whole situation.
それは信じよう。
え、そんな
Yeah, I'll believe her.
証明できないんだからしょうがないだろ。
I mean, she used it to save us. Watase admonished Jun, then turned back to Enna.
でも先生、どうしてそれを今まで隠してたの？そっちの方が問題だ。
あの時は仕方なかったのよ。死体を見た直後で脱出口も断たれていて、自分の身は自分で守らなきゃってそう思ってしまったんだもの。
Now that she mentioned it, Anna had mentioned the killer several times right after that incident. She kept on insisting that a killer was still in the facility. Was that because she just found that gun? And because she was preparing to protect herself? I guess she checked to see if it was loaded? Anna continued as Watase pondered that.
その後は、言うタイミングを逃してしまって。ごめんなさい。
It's okay. It's fine.Anna said that in a feeble voice. Ukita and Jun replied with their voices laced in bitterness. Don't give it to Ukita. Do not give it to Ukita. Okay, I'm okay with Jun having it.
ここは年長者の僕が預かるのが筋じゃないかね。
何言ってるのよ、二人とも。私が銃を持ってるのも変だけど、あなたたちが持っているのも危険じゃない。
何？
何？ Jun, Ukita, and Anna were all glaring at each other fiercely. Watase felt a shiver run down his spine as he saw that.What are they saying? Are they planning to start fighting each other over the gun? I can't talk. But that's nothing new. Ukita definitely not. Moribe more than Tsubakiyama. Yep. It was likely that a fight really would break out if he did next soon. Watase frantically rose his voice.
だったら、Moribe.銃はお前が扱うんだ、
yes. え？どうして森部さんなのよ。
先生とおっさんは素人だろ。だったらここはプロの森部に任せるのが正解だ。
Yep.
プロって、あなたたちはレスキューのプロであって銃の扱いなんて知らないはずよ。
Look, firing a gun and aiming a fire hose isn't that different, okay? It's basically the same thing.
Hey, 何をごちゃごちゃと。いいからその銃をこっちに渡すんだ。
Ukita, you go to timeout. And thus, a quarrel broke out. The four of them were soon shouting whatever they liked back and forth at each other. And after having wasted more than enough time, Watase finally interrupted them.
ちょっと待ってくれ、みんな。これじゃ拉致が開かない。
I'll leave it as is and we'll see what happens. Obviously, somebody could die because of this.
じゃあどうしようっていうのさ。
待てお前ら、それ以上揉めるつもりならそいつは俺が預かる。
I don't like that this chapter is called accidental shooting. Watase then tried to snatch the pistol from Anna. But then Ukita, oh my god, Ukita, I knew it.
ダメだ、君に持たせるくらいなら僕が持った方が安全だ。
Dude, I trust you the least, okay?
さあ椿山さん、それをこっちによこすんだ。
No!
ちょっと、だからその銃は私が持つって言ってんじゃん。 やめなさい、二人とも。
Ukita and Jun reached for Anna's pistol. The three of them began fighting over the gun.
おい、やめろ、みんなやめるんだ。
Watase grew impatient and tried to tear his three companions, now practically wrestling each other for the gun, off of each other. Just then, I'm gonna get shot. I'm sorry, I shouldn't laugh, but... Watase heard a dry sound, followed by what felt like something punching him straight in the heart. He looked down and saw a small hole had been bored in the dead center of his chest.
Nanda.
When he said that, a gurgling sound echoed from his throat. Something welled up and clogged his trachea. It hurt. Watase coughed it up. It was blood. Why?Just then, he felt the heat slowly but steadily spread around his lungs. He was then assaulted with scorching pain a second later. Watase groaned and grabbed his chest. His palm was soaked with warm, dark red blood. See, Ukita, look what you did. Look what you caused. Even though Enna fired the gun. Watase looked closer to find that all three of their hands were wrapped around the gun, and that the muzzle was pointed straight at him for some reason. Watase vomited blood again. He felt strength leaving the core of his body a moment later. He fell to his knees. His body then lurched forward. When his cheek came into contact with the cold floor, a chill rapidly spread throughout his entire body. Watase's energy grew fainter with each time that he vomited blood. Jun was desperately shouting something right above him. Enna was doing the same. But the words merely sounded like white noise ringing in Watase's ear. Just then, a light suddenly faded from his eyes. His consciousness sank into darkness. And then, as Watase lay there, not knowing if he'd been shot by accident or on purpose, his heart stopped. Ukita did it. Alrighty. Okay, so maybe we'll let Enna keep the gun so people don't fight over it. The result of Watase mishandling gun situation by trying too hard to have things his way. Okay. Got it. That is fine. Well, it's not fine, but it's okay. I don't 100% disagree with what happened. It's just kind of funny. Let's just say it. I still am curious about this title screen, though. You see that axe back there? And now we know that an axe is missing? Yeah. Seriously. Okay, don't want to go to accidental shooting, so I want to go here. Okay, so... Anna, Watase, and June. And maybe this will work? That's still accidental shooting. Hang on. That's still accidental shooting. I see you. I see you over there, Mr. Accidental Shooting. Who? I don't want to give it to... Okay. Do I need to give it to Moribe? It was likely a fight would break out if he did next soon. Watase frantically raised his voice. Moribe. This is the same. Okay, so I'm gonna lower everybody except for Moribe. Okay, that's better. At least we didn't get shot. Okay, Jun, I understand where you're coming from. Did you see the bodies riddled with bullets? That wasn't from a pistol. It's not gonna help. Okay, fine, we'll each hold a piece, and then if we need to shoot somebody, we'll assemble our parts, and then we can shoot the person. How's that sound? The gears in Watase's mind rotated at high speed, and then produced him the best answer. Oh my god, are they really gonna do that?
Okay.
Yep, and now you know where Dangan for Dangan Ronpa comes in.
Anyways.
Because Dangan means bullet, in case you're trying to figure out what's going on. So we are splitting it. This is amazing. It's like the Avengers. We're gonna assemble so we can shoot somebody. Everyone's eyes widened at Watase's proposal. Watase may have sounded composed on the outside, but he was panicking on the inside. This gun just had to show up, and when everybody is already as unstable as it was, it's too dangerous to keep around. I gotta resolve this thing peacefully. Watase kept speaking in the gentlest voice he could in order to hide his fears. I was saying it as a joke because it seemed like a stupid idea.
逆にテロリストが現れなかった時は全員平等に無力だ。 みんな安心だろ、これで。
でも
納得してくれよ、先生。俺は早いとこ、こんなバカげたことは終わらせたいんだ。
I'd rather not get shot again. Silence reigned over the group for a while. Anna soon let out an exasperated sigh.
わかったわ。隊長さんの言う通りにするわ。
Thank you. Then took the magazine out of the gun. She then awkwardly took the bullets out of the magazine and the gun's chamber. There were 11 of them in total.
これでいいの？
あ、問題ないだろう。しかし誰が何を持つのか。
We're each gonna hold on to a piece and you'll get nothing.
どうでもいいっちゃいいが、そうだよ。おっさんが重心。
You're giving him the gun?
先生が弾倉。モリベが弾丸でいいんじゃない。
You're giving him the gun part. I don't think that's a good idea.
え、隊長は？
俺はいいよ。リーダーシップは何も持たない方がいい。
なるほどね。ならばひとまず安心か。
じゃあ私もかなわないよ。
I'm just worried if they found the gun in the facility on somebody, then Ukita might find other bullets or magazines later on. I know I'm like casting a lot of shade toward Ukita, right? But he is... I just don't like him. Anna then gave Ukita the gun and the bullets to Jim.
これで問題は解決だな。
そうだね。バッチリだね。
ほっとしたよ。
ええ。
The three of them seemed placated for the time being. But Watase was thinking about something completely different. He's hungry. Why did the gun already have bullets in it when Teach found it? If the gun had belonged to the terrorist Jun mentioned, then why was it laying by the lift? If it had been empty, then it would have made more sense.That would have meant the terrorists had probably discarded it on purpose. But who would ever get rid of a loaded gun? Got a point. Then that would mean that the owner hadn't got rid of it, but dropped it. Or maybe they left it there? Was it in order to give it to us? The gun was now split up into three parts. Watase wondered if this call had, if this had all been a trap someone set up to drive a rift between the group.But everything was stable for the time being. Now the group had to pull themselves together and continue with the search whether they liked it or not. Watase addressed the others with that thought in his mind.
さて、なんだかんだで、立花以外は全員揃っちまったな。俺たちの組は第5エリアからぐるっと回ってここまで来た。森部たちの組は何か見つけられたか？
いや、ユリちゃんも誰もいなかったし、AD も見つからなかったよ。そうね。脱出口もね。
おっさんは？
君らと別れてからほんの20分くらいしか経ってないじゃないか。もちろん何も見つかってない。
Yeah, but I don't trust him. Like always, their search had yielded nothing.
そうだ。何か気になったこととかはあるか？
Watase said that as a way to basically say, did anyone spot Staryu? But then Jun gave a surprising answer.
そういえば、高いことだけど。
Yes?
なんかあの、鼻の匂い、パッタリしなくなったね。
What? Watase was totally confused by her comment.
鼻の匂いって。
いや、ほら、施設内に時々漂ってたじゃん。嗅いだことない？
そんなのあったっけ？
I don't know what you're talking about. Watase then glanced at Ukita and Anna.
ああ、そういえばそんな匂いしてたね。
どうかしら、嗅いでない気がするけど。
Two contradicting statements. It just didn't make sense to Watase. The four of them, plus Kazami and Yuri, had traveled through the entire facility together, yet Watase and Anna didn't smell anything, while Jun and Ukita did.
なんだそれ、何の匂いなんだ。
いや、本当細かいことだから、そんな引っ張らなくていいよ。
Somebody's perfume?
それより隊長たちは？なんか気になることあった？
No, we totally didn't see a child that thought it was suspicious or anything. Watase said that and changed his train of thought.
実は俺と先生はさっきサリを見かけたんだが、また逃げられてしまったんだ。
また？ なんで？
She don't like us.
わからん。
Saryu's words crossed his mind for a moment. Be careful of that captain. He's a dangerous man. But Anna didn't bring that up, perhaps out of consideration for
Wata-san.
That's the only thing you were worried about? Everyone nodded at Ukita's comment. Sure. I'm being way too harsh on Ukita, I get it. Can we go get her? Because like, I'm really worried we're going to go back one time and then she's going to be dead. The group then started to walk off. Anna was walking in front of the others. She was fiddling around with her PDA, probably to check her map. Watase walked up to her and whispered in her ear.
Sensei.
That's not a whisper, that's like a straight up shout. Anna turned around in surprise. She put away her PDA and spoke in a sharp voice.
Clever
girl. Especially Ukita. Anna was speaking in a type of intensity that she'd never used before. I trust you, so there we go. A silent edge different from all her back talk and hysteric shouting that could be felt from her. Oops, I cut her off. My bad! I'm not a student, though. Really? That's really what you're gonna say? I mean, like, okay, so if you have amnesia, do you get a second first kiss? Is that how that works? I mean, because, like, obviously, Watase had a relationship before, but we might be... I don't know what I'm talking about. I'm just like, is that another first? Or, like, what happens? Is she younger than us? I don't remember. The group arrived at Area 6 while they were talking. Watase began handing out orders once they arrived at the factory.
Alright,
let's do this. With those words, Watase then parted ways with Anna's team. Area 6, Inner Ring, B2. Watase and Ukita were searching the area, but they couldn't find anything. They headed for the emergency staircase. The staircase in that dim stairwell had collapsed, but the rope Watase had used to climb up earlier was still right where he'd left it. You can't climb up like a rope? but Watase realized something before he finished speaking. He was feeling quite tired. Could he really climb up the rope with Ukita on his back in this shape? If the two of us fall together by any chance, we'll both get badly hurt. I climb up and then I pull the rope while you hang onto it for dear life. Or I could go by myself. That's all three pieces of the gun. Are you sure you want to do that? Can I have the gun, please? Ukita nodded, then left the stairwell. I feel like I'm making bad choices. Watase promptly climbed the rope to the upper floor. Area 6, Inner Ring B1. Watase began searching the block by himself. But he didn't find Yuri or any of the other survivors in the rooms. Time was passing by and he still hadn't secured any more AD. He figured he should go to the factory and meet up with Ukita and the others. But just as he thought that, the PC monitor in the room suddenly caught Watase's eye. He hadn't noticed it the last time he'd been there. The monitor was still on. It appeared the PC was frozen. On screen was what appeared to be a text file that someone had been editing. Test subjects IGF2R gene type, okay? Subject A, hereditary IGF2R gene abnormality, type S deceased. Subject N, type S. Subject Y, which is going to be Yuri, right? Right? Type 4, showed no signs of genetic mutation via WX particles discarded. Wait, there's more than one subject Y. Y2, acquired IGF2R gene abnormality, type S. Okay, why is discarding? No precedent regarding releases, expected problems, memory, recovery, etc. Okay. What is all this? Oh god, I can't read all this. Let's see. Hereditary IGF2R gene abnormality type S. Okay. Target KA, hereditary IGF2R gene abnormality type B or type D. Observation target MA, hereditary IGF2R gene abnormality type B. MA's level 5, consider irradiation test. NA, subject N, April 7th, 2021, subject Y, YU. So I think it's Yuri, September 10th, 2030. Nothing he saw on the screen meant anything to Watase. And yet, he felt a mysterious chill run through him the moment he saw all those entries for some reason. At the exact moment he muttered that, strange images flickered through Watase's brain. What is that picture? Oh, is that little girl crazy? Is that what's going on? He didn't recognize any of those images. Perhaps they were remnants of his memories of the past. But they were accompanied by intense fear and unpleasant feelings that assaulted him. He didn't know why, but just being there was terrifying and made him disgusted enough to throw up. Watase left the room as if he were running away from it. I've felt this before. He headed for the stairwell as he pondered when that was. As he descended the rope, he slowly began to realize it. It was fairly recently, wasn't it? No, a bit earlier than that. He searched for the truth behind his fear, and then he finally remembered just as he descended the rope. It was when he'd entered the contamination zone to look for Yuri after she'd run off. He remembered her saying that. That's right. Now that I think about it, Yuri said something strange back then. He'd felt the same strange sense of dread back then for some reason. Why had he forgotten about it until now? Shocked, Watase watched as the Yuri in his memory spoke.
Really?
少しで死んでしまうところでした。
Okay.
火の中に置き去りにされて。
I think that's when we first met her, but I don't know how she got in that situation.
ユーリ、何を言っているんだ。
あなたにわからないんだったら、私にもわかりません。私には。わからないです。だからお願いです。隊長さん、教えてください。あなたの心。
Yuri said that and turned her palm towards Watase. A strange image spread right out there before him. That sight overlapped with Yuri.Nice scream. That was right. Yuri had indeed said all that. He'd completely forgotten about the encounter, even though it only happened about an hour ago. He thought about it, then suddenly gasped after a few seconds. Could it be my memory impairment? Is it actually healing with time?But only getting worse instead. Watase shuddered at the thought. That would be interesting. But that wasn't the only thing that horrified him. There was also the fact that Watase had felt a clear fear for Yuri and that memory he'd just recovered. Why would I ever be scared of Yuri? Just then, even more incomprehensible words passed through Watase's brain as if to only confuse him further. What?Test subjects or something? The test subjects are dangerous. Yeah! I can play Wheel of whatever it's called. Fortune? What the hell was that? What the hell were those words? I don't know them. I've never heard those words before. Watase drowned out those words along with the unpleasant feelings he felt. Now fearing the darkness and seeking the light, he opened the door into the stairwell. But when the faint light shone in from outside, Watase felt a horrible shiver down his spine. Something about to happen. He got the feeling that in the shadow of the debris of the emergency staircase, a blind spot that he hadn't paid attention to when climbing, something was hiding. His heartbeat skyrocketed. It appeared to be lying on the floor. Watase timidly peeked behind the shadow of the debris and found himself face to face with an unbelievable sight. Oh, no! Watase's voice sounded empty. A small body lying on the ground. Yuri. No! Eyes that had lost all light. Watase saw all of that.
Yuri.
She didn't even respond after he called her name. Her body didn't twitch. A single streak of dark red blood adorned her pale face. That blood had long since gone dry. Watase ran over to her. All the fear he'd been feeling a short time ago vanished in an instant.
Yuri! Yuri!
He sat Yuri up as he shouted her name, but her head dangled feebly. She wasn't breathing. Her body had gone cold. That was, without a doubt, Yuri's corpse.
Baka na! Douste!
I don't know.
Douste konna koto ni!
There was no one who could answer that question. Watase instinctively held Yuri's ice-cold body close to his chest, and at that moment, the memories of her passed through his head. He heard that voice in his head when he'd first seen her. It was at that moment that Watase had decided to do everything he could to protect her.
それで、そっちのお嬢ちゃんの名前は？
But she was wary of him at first, preventing them from reaching a mutual understanding. Yet despite that, she started opening her heart to him little by little. Watase acted all in accordance with his desire to keep her safe. Yuri. Those had been Watase's honest feelings. Thus, when the factory's ceiling collapsed, Watase acted without a moment's hesitation. Oh yeah, he asked her to say save me.
Yuri, 安心しろ. 絶対にお前を助けてやるからな.
He kept trying to protect her no matter what was thrown his way. He tried to escape the facility so that he could get her out to safety. But she'd run away. Then Watase had led her out of his sight because of some incomprehensible fear he'd felt for her. And now, he'd finally found her again. Only to discover that the Yuri he'd last seen was gone forever. Why? Just when she finally started opening up to me a little. Fierce regret raged within him. Sorrow then filled his heart. The sound of a watch's hands ticking filled the otherwise silent room. And thus, before she could ever tell Watase anything about what she meant back then, the source of his fear for her, and what she'd been feeling about him the whole time, Yuri had fallen into an eternal silence. Watase was in a daze for a while. He had no clue how long he'd been like that. Soon enough.
Oi, omae, shikkari shiro. Itsu made bouzen to shite run da? Hayaku minna no tokoro ni ike.
Okay. Watase finally came back to his senses after hearing the now familiar auditory hallucination. It's like, hey, hallucination, how's it going? He realized he'd been strolling through like a zombie through the inner ring's hallway without even being aware of it. He turned around and saw the door to the stairwell behind him. That's right. I have to tell everyone what happened. No matter how painful that may be. Watase mustered his nearly torn heart and headed for the factory. When he got there, he found Jun, Enna, and Ukita.
Taicho! どうしたの? その青白い顔して...
Everybody ran up to him. Ukita looked at his watch and spoke. Yeah, I found the body. Okay. Watase answered in a shaky voice.
Yuri.
Everyone's eyes widened.
バカな。彼女が死んでるだと?
Jiko.
She was killed. Watase took the others with him and headed back for the stairwell in the inner ring. Is the body going to be gone?
ここだ.
Watase stopped in front of the stairwell. His companions all gulped. Watase paused as he felt a cold sweat roll down his back, and then opened the door. Is she gonna be gone? But, oh! There was nothing there! Oh! Nothing but the wreckage of the collapsed staircase. Ukita and the others looked puzzled. By the time Watase could speak again, his voice was leaden with disbelief. Is there like blood on the rubble or anything? Watase searched the cramped stairwell. But he couldn't find the body no matter how hard he looked. Ukita let out an exasperated sigh when he heard that. Okay, so... if we see Yuri again, there might be two. There might be twins, because it was like, why one and why two? So there might be two of them, and that might be the other one that was quote-unquote discarded. Maybe. I'm just throwing stuff out there. I'm sure none of it's gonna stick, but that's where my head's going right now. So there's not even blood stains either. Do you have blood on your shirt? Or your uniform? Watase was rendered speechless at that. He just confirmed with his own eyes that there was indeed no body or blood stains anywhere to be found. And it did say we can't trust our perception. Watase felt shivers down his spine. For Ukita's theory, it made total sense. Then, did that mean that the auditory hallucinations he'd been hearing for the past few hours and his constant headache and nausea were the result of brain damage? To make matters worse, he'd also been suffering from radiation damage on top of that. Has my brain been damaged past the point of no return? Watase desperately tried to find another plausible explanation for everything, but I can't think of anything. In the first place, he didn't even have any clue why he had amnesia to begin with, or what had happened before he lost his memories. Meaning that thinking about his condition wouldn't help him at all. If only I could remember what situation just before I lost my memories was like. If only I could remember what happened a few hours ago, then I might be able to finally answer some of my questions. Like the truth behind my condition and what's been happening in this facility today. It felt like he was totally lacking in the knowledge he needed to understand all that. Just then, Ukita's voice interrupted his thoughts. I'm listening. Watase gritted his teeth and mustered a response. Not the Yuri I saw. You said she was cold to the touch, buddy.
そんなことってあると思う。ほんの数分の間の出来事でしょ。いいからみんなで手分けして探そう。森部と俺は地下1階を、先生たちは地下2階を頼む。うん、隊長が言うならもちろん従うけどさ。こんなところで時間を割いていていいのかね。それじゃせめて5分だけでも頼む。5分経ったらまたここに集まろう。
Though they were reluctant, Watase managed to persuade everyone. Thus, it began the search for Yuri. But no matter how hard they searched, they couldn't find Yuri anywhere. The group reunited at the stairwell 5 minutes later. Watase couldn't say anything in the face of everyone's stares. The ghost was just withered grass? It said that's in the tips, and I still don't actually know where the tips are, but that's fine. He couldn't impress his own belief on them any longer. Either way, it's true that we wasted time. Watase reluctantly withheld his opinion and changed gears. Yeah, that would be better, but somebody's dead. Watase said that to convince himself. But something was clearly happening here. Watase continued talking as he felt that ominous premonition in his mind.
Yeah.
I haven't seen the bestest character in this entire episode yet. If she's dead, I'm ending the episode. I'm just telling you right now. The group thus headed on over to the near neuroscience laboratory. But Kazami wasn't there. Instead, the group... Oh god, the group was greeted with a shocking sight! What? What? It wasn't what they saw that was strange. It was what they didn't see that was strange.
Lady Eagle!
Oh! The 80s I'd left in the neuroscience laboratory was all gone.
そんな...
That's not good. All they found were torn scraps of the paper scattered on the floor. Watase picked one of them up. It read to Mr. Tenkawa. They were ripped up remnants of Emma's note.
どうして?
Everyone was frozen in shock. Watase couldn't speak. He quickly checked his Prokion to find that it read 5,928 millisieverts. The radiation levels throughout the entire facility were all probably past the first danger standard by the point. Kazumi had indeed managed to survive for an hour only on half of an AD before, but she also mentioned that she hadn't been feeling well during that time. Plus, the radiation levels were completely different then. If things didn't turn for the better soon, it was most likely only a matter of time before they exceeded the second danger standard. And the last time I was in a contaminated zone, He suffered from intense headaches and nausea after only a few minutes in there. He shuddered at the thought of that happening to everyone else.
どうしてこんなことに?
Bizarre events just kept happening one after the other. Watase gritted his teeth. Ukita then spoke up. I'm gonna cut you off mid-sentence there. What? What's happening? Moribe, I will leave that all the way up, but we'll see. I don't know about that. June scanned the others with a sharp look in her eye.
ちょっと待て、モリベ。お前、自分が何を言ってるのか分かってるのか?
だって、そうとしか考えられないじゃない! このラボにいるのは、私たちと夏彦君たちだけなんだよ! でも私には、 夏彦君たちが無断でADを持ち去ったとは思えないよ。あの子たちがいい子なのは知ってるし、掟神も破られてんじゃん。だったら私たちの中に犯人がいるって考えるのが当然でしょ?ねえ、単独行動を取っていたのは誰?みんなアリバイ証明できる?
Watase was dumbfounded at the fierce look June was giving them all. Just then, Anna sighed and spoke.
確かに、私たちには アリバイがないわね
先生?
隊長さんも、私も、浮田さんも 一人で行動していた時間帯がある でもね アリバイがないのはあなたも同じよ、モリベさん
Anna gave June a pointed glare
負傷してから、再び私たちの前に姿を現すまで あなたが何をしていたか証明できる人もいないでしょ
何言ってんの? 私があの部屋で休んでたのは椿山さんも知ってるじゃん。すぐに回復したとしたら?
そもそも、怪しいと叫ぶ人こそ、むしろ怪しいのではない。
Somebody's been playing some Among Us.
はぁ? 何それ? まさか私がADを隠したとでも言いたいの?
その可能性も否めないわ。
ふざけんな!
Jun, you're a little, unreasonable right now. Anna trembled in the face of June's mad roar. She's stressed. She's hit her boiling point. Is the lieutenant gonna step in, please? Jun gave Anna the deadliest glare she could, then started panting heavily once she finished talking. Tears were pouring down her cheeks. Anna was absolutely speechless. She looked away in regret.
ごめんなさい。あなたもその仕事に命を懸けてるってわけね。
そうだよ。いつ だってそうあろうと思ってんだよ。
Just as Jun said that in a shaky voice.
だが、レスキュー隊の全員がそう思っているかどうかはわからない。
Ukita interjected.
おっさん、
職業倫理と個人的思想は必ずしも一致しない。職責より個人の主義主張を貫くことを良しとする者もいる。
Gonna save and disagree. Oh god. What? Why them? Hold on. That's a weird... That's a weird set of choices.
いやいや、待ちたまえ。
僕が疑っているのは、
Watase couldn't take it anymore and shouted as another quarrel began to break out.
もういい、やめろみんな。もう仲間同士のいがみ合いを見るのはたくさんだ。
Yeah, come on, we fought over the gun. We gotta stick together.
どうしてもっと仲間を信じようとしないんだ。置き手紙が破られてたからなんだ。要求助者が AD を持っていっただけかもしれないだろう。何の確証もないのに仲間を疑うなんて、そんなのは間違ってる。
ではどうやって確証を得ようというの？
監視ルームだ。
監視ルーム？
監視ルームで立花がカメラを確認している。それに何か。
Oh thank God, we finally get to see Tachibana. Come on, Kazumi. Kazumi had told him she'd go to the neuroscience laboratory when she'd healed up.But the fact that she wasn't there meant she was probably still recovering.
しかし、監視カメラはほとんど壊れていたがね。
ほとんどだろ？ってことは、全部じゃない。だったら、確かめてみる価値はあるはずだ。ここで罵り合ってるより、その方がずっとマシだ。
Jun, Anna, and Ukita were all silent. Eventually, Jun spoke up in a soft voice.
うん、そうだね。行こうよ、みんな。
Please be okay.Please be okay. She'd be an awesome detective. She'd figure out who the killer is and then beat the crap out of them. Jin surveyed the others with a fierce glare.
Yeah, そんなことはありえない。俺たち仲間を信じるための証拠を見つけに行く。
The group then hurried on over to the surveillance room.Watase suddenly felt an unpleasant sensation in his skin as he ran over to the surveillance room. It was just like the time he'd been in the contaminated zone. Oh no, Watase checked his watch. He then realized it was already past time for them to take their AD.
しまった。みんな、AD を投与しろ。
わかったよ。
The group then administered themselves with AD. Now they had none left at all.
AD が切れた途端。肌に痛みを感じたわ。
Okay. Now they really were in an environment where they couldn't live without AD.
急ごう。早く AD の所在を明らかにするんだ。
The group nodded and started running again. Area 3, Inner Ring B2. The group were now right outside the surveillance room. Watase moved to open the door, but then...
やめて。
What? He heard a voice from inside.
今の声は立花か?
Just then, she started talking again.
どうして、あなたがそれを知っている。まさか、本当に。
What? He couldn't hear the voice behind the door all that well, but it seemed like she was talking to someone.
隊長、ぼーっとしてないで扉を開けてよ。
Watase restrained his confusion and opened the door.
Wait!
What? Kazumi shouted at the same time Watase opened the door. She then looked at the group and her face froze over.
Taichou, それに皆さんも
Tachibana, 一人か?
Kazumi was the only one in the surveillance room.
そうですけど、誰かいるように見えますか?見えないけど。
俺はてっきりお前が誰かと言い争っているかと思ったんだが。
それは。
What was that?
無線です。
無線？
はい、先ほど一瞬地上の誰かとつながって、
okay.
しかしすぐ途切れてしまいました。
Of course I'm gonna trust her. Are you kidding me?
切れた瞬間、思わず待ってと叫んでしまいましたが。
Kazumi looked at the floor as she relayed all that in a feeble voice. Is that true? Of course it is! He wondered that for a moment, but then he decided against prying any further. He didn't want to make all the doubt still palpable within the group even stronger. Yeah, they need to trust each other. He just chalked it up to yet another bizarre incident. Watase then moved on to the pressing issue at hand.
Tachibana, これは念のために聞くんだが、お前、AD をこっちに持ってきたりしてないよな。
え？それはどういう意味でしょう？私はここに来てから一歩も外に出ていませんが。
そう。
何かあったんですか？
It's missing.
実は、脳科学実験室に置いてあった AD が誰かに持ってかれちまったみたいなんだ。
え？
それで監視カメラ映像に何か残ってないか調べてみようと思ってな。
Watase looked at Kazumi when he said that. Knowing her, he'd figured she'd readily comply with their request. However,
What?
Tachibana.
Kazumi then answered without looking at Watase.
隊長、残念ながら脳科学実験室の近くに生きている監視カメラはありません。
Okay.
そうなのか。
私は徹底的にここにある撮影映像をチェックしていました。生きているカメラは第一エリア外周棟に2つ、第二エリア内周棟に2つ、第三エリア外周棟に1つ、それから第四エリア外周棟に1つと第六エリア内周棟に2つだけです。
第六エリア内周棟？
はい、非常階段のところと通路に一つずつです。
OK、
じゃあそれにユーリが映ってないか。
Yeah.
ユーリさんですか。ユーリさんが単独で映っている映像は残念ながらありませんでしたが。
None, huh?
待て、第六エリア付近で映っているはずだ。
なぜそう思うのですか。
Ukita answered in Watase stead。
いやね、彼が第六エリアの非常階段でユーリ君の死体を見たというのだ。
ユーリさんの死体？
まさかと思って僕らもその現場に行ってみたら何もなかったんだね。
だが監視カメラの映像を見れば俺の見たものが本当かどうかわかる。20分ほど前の映像だ。再生してみてくれ。
わかりました。
It depends on how she died though. She was in the stairwell like a floor above and came down, then it won't show on that video feed, right? Kazumi said that and replayed the surveillance camera footage. Archive footage showing the emergency staircase and Area 6's inner ring played on the monitor. Watase and Ukita soon showed up. Everyone's eyes were fixed on the monitor.
そうだ。俺はここでおっさんと別れて。
The footage showed Ukita walking away from Watase, followed by the latter climbing the rope. Watase soon finished up his search of B1 and came back.
この直後だ。俺はここで足を止めて、ユーリの死体を見たんだ。
Watase leaned forward. However, the footage showed Watase heading straight out of the stairwell without stopping. Really? The timestamp displayed on the monitor was 13:52:12. The time matched up with Watase's memories, but...
死体見つけてない。
どうして？
Watase muttered that, then heard a low voice behind him.
隊長さん、どういうことかね。
Watase turned around in surprise to find Ukita scowling right at him.
どういうことって。
死体を発見するどころか素通りしているじゃないか。なぜ嘘をつくのかね。
Is it like crossing time continuums or something? Watase couldn't answer that question.
おかしなことはもう一つある。この映像の時刻だ。13時52分。この時刻に君は階段室を出て行ったようだが、君がファクトリーに姿を現したのは 13時58分だったんだよ。
何？
浮田さん、それ本当？
ああ、腕時計を見て確認したから間違いない。
Now that he thought about it, Ukita did say, "You sure took quite some time. Did something happen when they regrouped in the factory?" Watase had thought the time lag had been because he'd been shocked and out of it from finding a body, but...
内周島からファクトリーまで歩いて6分もかかるわけがない。
I'm gonna trust myself over Ukita, even if I'm unreliable.
空白の6分間、君はどこで何をしていたのかね。
いや、あの時は死体を見た直後で動転していて、はっと気づくと内周島の廊下を歩いていたが、どこで何をしていたのかまでは。
だがその事実はなかった。そもそも死体なんて映像に映っていないじゃないか。
違う、俺は確かにあの時、
His memory of finding Yuji's body was still crystal clear in Watase's mind. But his subjective memory had been smashed into pieces by Ukita's rebuttal and the objective video footage.
どういうことだって?
そんなものは決まってるさ。彼は嘘をついていたんだよ。
嘘ですって。
But like, why would I want to see surveillance footage of that if I know it's a lie, right? Like...If I know it's going to be disproven, then why would I even bother with it? It doesn't make any sense.
ああ、ありもしない死体を見たなどと言って、それを言い訳にファクトリーに来るのを遅らせたんだ。そしてその隙にこっそり AD を盗みに行ったんだろう。
Really? Really, guys? Everyone gasped at Ukita's, accusation.
違う、そんなわけないだろう。
では6分間も何をしていたというのかね。この一刻を争う状況下で。
Watase instinctively fell quiet, overwhelmed by confusion.
どうしたの、隊長？なんで黙ってるの？隊長は私たちを騙してたの？
Not knowingly.
違う。本当に何が起きたのか、俺にもわからないんだよ。
なるほどなるほど。自分が信じられないか。それもこれも記憶障害のせいというわけ
だ。How about I give you some amnesia so you know what it feels like to struggle with this? Although you won't remember how much of a moron you're being, but you know, hey, whatever.
それは同時に、君が今まで語ってきた言葉のすべてが信頼性を失うことと同義なのだよ。
何？
先ほど AD が亡くなっていさかいが起きた時、君は僕らを戒めた。自分は犯人じゃないという顔をして。だが、ありもしない死体を、幻覚を見るような人間の言うことをどうやって信じろというのだね。君が AD をどこかに隠して、それを忘れているだけかもしれないじゃないか。
That would be kind of funny, actually.
バカな！そんなことあるわけがない！俺は正気だ！
正気？ならば君は嘘つきということになる。死体はなかったし、AD も君が盗んだんだろう。
It was then that Watase realized it. Whether he was sane or not, it didn't change that fact either way. His words were no longer trustworthy.
お待ちください。問題は、なぜそんな奇妙な嘘をついたのかということですが。
さあね。だがそう考えると、彼のすべてが疑わしくなる。
Alright, he'd be good at Among Us, but I still don't like
him. 例えば、そう。隊長さんが戻ったと言っていた記憶が真実なのかとかね。君は要救助者を助けるため地下に降りてきたという。だがそれもまた嘘で、本当は別の目的のために降りてきたんじゃないのかね。
別の目的って
決まってるさ。殺人のためだ。
What? Watase gasped with shock. Ukita continued.
そう、これはテロなどではない、計画的な殺人なんだよ。
You think somebody went through all of this to murder someone?
例えばこんな推理は成り立たないかね。君は同僚の堂島隊員に対し、何らかの理由で殺意を抱いた。
For some reason.
そして災害現場で殺害することにした。火災がひどい場所で殺してしまえば死体は焼けてしまう。そうなれば事故死ということで片付けた。そう考えた君は、 今回の事件を機に計画を実行に移した。
That is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
だがそれをあの2名の研究員たちに目撃された。そして口封じのために殺したんだ。
That is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. No, I trust myself.
檜山隊員は辛くも逃げ出したが、結局火に巻かれて死んでしまった。ことによればユーリ君も、そしてリフトのところで死んでいたあの子も目撃者なのかもしれない。ああそうだ、君が会うたびに逃げられてる三宮君も目撃者の一人かもね。
Is anybody gonna come to my aid here?
やめろ、そんなのデタラメだ。俺がそんなことをするわけないだろ。
したという保証はない。だがしなかったという保証も一切ない。
That's the flimsiest argument ever. Well, there's no proof that you did or didn't, so...
そのことは君自身が重々承知しているんじゃないのかね。
Watase looked around seeking help. He locked eyes with Kazumi. A troubled look rose to her face.
Tachibana... 俺は...あの堂島という隊員を殺したいほど憎んでいたのか。
わかりません。
You don't know?
わからないって、そんな素振りがあったかどうかくらい。
わからないんですよ、本当に。
Those words sent blood rushing to... Oh god, no, that was bad. That was all kinds of bad. Did you see all the negatives? Hang on.
俺はあの堂島という隊員を
殺
したいほど憎んでいたのか。
わかりま、
わからないって、そんな素振りがあったかどうかくらい。
わからないんですよ、だって隊長はご自分のことを何も話してくださらないから。
Whew, okay, that's better. Kazumi looked at Watase with sad eyes.
自分のことを話さない。
記憶喪失になる前のあなたは人と距離を置き、
But we had history though.
自分が何を考えているのか誰にも語ろうとしなかったんです。私にも。
Kazumi said that in a pained voice. Jun then spoke up.
そういえば私も。
Maybe that's why we broke up?
何も知らない、仕事のつながりしかない。
Well, that's not good. Watase was astonished. He thought that Kazumi and Jun would trust him, just as he trusted them. Yet they didn't trust not only the Watase without his memories, but even the him from when he had his memories. This isn't happening. Watase's feet started shaking. Jun glared at him and spoke.
隊長、私たちには本当のこと
を
言
って。
Could y'all not? 本当は何が目的地下に降りてきたの。隊長が持ち場から離れるなんて本来なら絶対ありえないんだよ。ねえ、教えてよ。隊長は人の命を救うために
ここに来たんじゃないの。 I don't like it.
もしそうじゃなかったとしたら、私絶対隊長を許せないの。
Anger was slowly building in Jun's eyes. No, it wasn't as simple as anger. It was the intent to kill. Jun glared at Watase with bloodthirsty eyes. He wanted to say she was wrong, but he couldn't. He knew anything he said there would sound hollow. Yet he tried to say something, but just then...
待ちなさい、二人とも!
Anna spoke up.
あなたたち少しおかしいわよ。
何？どの辺が？
ああ、実に正論だったと思うがね。
それがまともじゃないって言うのよ。あなたたち、隊長さんに何度も助けられたんじゃないの？何なのよ。AD が亡くなった途端、手のひら返したように。それがまともな人間のすること？
Thank you, Anna.
それとこれとは話が別だよ。今の話聞いて、どうして椿山さんは隊長の味方するの？よく知りもしない他人でしょ？まさか、 人はグルだったのか。
ジュン、what is going on?
何を言ってるの。
That sudden accusation left Anna with a confused look on her face. But Ukita kept up the assault before she had time to counter.
そうか、なるほど。道理で行動がおかしいと思ったら。
Really? Really?
ようやくわかったぞ。君たちは二人だけで助かろうというつもりなんだな。
Ukita has the gun. If Anna and I were in cahoots to kill everyone and leave on our own, why would we split up the gun?
AD を隠したのは君たちか。二人で AD を独占しているんだ。
What? Ukita and Jun were glaring at Watase and Anna. It was then that Watase finally realized it. Their eyes were full of madness. This isn't good. They really are out of their minds. Now that he thought about it, there were numerous factors that could be behind it. Their hours of built-up fatigue. The multiple strange happenings in this place. The feeling of entrapment from being stuck down here. The despair of not finding an exit. The fear from finding all those bodies. And then, the loss of the AD had driven the final nail in the coffin. That one act had dramatically shortened the group's lifespan. It's impossible to expect anyone to remain sane in these circumstances. Ukita and Jun prowled towards them. Just then, a voice echoed on Watase's head. Okay. Watase came back to his senses and took Anna by the arm. But at that moment... Jun and Ukita sprung at them. But Watase and Anna barely managed to dodge them in time. Uh-oh! Are we okay? Jun and Ukita slammed into the monitors. But they quickly turned around and glared at Watase and Anna. Watase instinctively looked away, only for his eyes to return to Kazami. Kazami was looking towards the exit. She then gave Watase a glance as if to say run.
Sensei, nigeruzo!
Watase took Anna's arm and ran out of the room. Oh my god, that was intense actually. I hope Kazami's okay. I hope they don't take it out on her. They are losing their mind. Watase and Anna had escaped their pursuers and were now hiding in a room in Area 2's inner ring.
そうね。でも本当に危なかったわ。あのまま捕まっていたら私たち殺されていたかもしれないわよ。殺されて？
Did you see the look in their eyes? A stern expression appeared on Anna's face when she heard his protest.
まだわからないの、隊長さん。この最悪の状況下で本当に怖いのは火でも煙でも放射線でもない。It's people。人間よ。追い詰められた人間のむき出しの悪意。それが一番怖いのよ。
Watase gasped. He thought that their only hope in this death-ridden facility had been the human will to survive. But now that things had gone to hell, it was likely the other way around. What happens when the human will to survive transcends human morals? Does it become the will to survive, even at the cost of killing others? Or maybe it becomes a conviction that killing others is justifiable if it means protecting someone else. In any normal situation, Ukita and Jun would probably never even dream about considering those things. But now everyone's lives were at risk. Their morals were most likely being shaved down to a layer of thin ice. Possibly enough to justify murder in their minds. How did things come to this? Why? I thought we were all on the same side here. The problem was whether the others felt the same way, and they probably didn't. Watase breathed a heavy sigh and turned to Enna.
な、先生。一つ聞いてもいいか?
何?
どうして先生はさっき俺をかばったんだ? 俺の記憶がどうであれ、ああいう映像記録が出てきてしまった以上、怪しいのは間違いないだろう。先生は俺に言ったよな。
Faced with the others having seemingly gone mad and beginning to doubt even his own memories, Watase wondered what Enna was truly after. Enna then spoke in a somewhat hesitant voice. I wish I knew too.
ねえ、隊長さん。あなたはユーリさんの遺体を見たと言ったわね。あのことについて 自分ではどう思ってるの?
あれは、おっさんの言う通り、幻を見たんだと思う。俺は記憶障害を起こしている。そこに何度も汚染区域に入ったりして、幻覚を見てもおかしくないさ。He
was reminded of something Kazumi had said way back then. Radiation exposure causes severely negative effects on the human body. This includes skin inflammation, nausea, organ failure, brain cell damage, oh, you think? Vision impairment, neurological disorders, genetic disorders, and cancer. Vision impairment, neurological disorders, and brain cell damage. Any one of those could have caused Watase to hallucinate seeing a corpse.
それに実は、目覚めてから時々幻聴も聞こえるんだ。幻聴?ああ。変に思われるのが嫌で、ずっと黙っていたが、俺は最初、 先生の言っていたBCってやつかと思ったんだ。だが、幻聴はともかく、人に幻覚を見せるBCなんて存在しないだろう。そうね。だから単に、俺の頭が変になっているだけかもしれない。Feelings
of abandonment seized Watase. The Procyon's reading was 5,672 millisieverts. They had less than an hour until their next AG injection. At this radiation level, they'd instantly show life-threatening symptoms of radiation exposure once their AD worn off.
大体考えてみりゃ、数値が常に第一危険基準値を超えるようになってから随分経つ。 AD でも被曝を防げるかどうかわからない線量の中に何時間もいるんだ。幻覚が見えるわけだぜ。Watase
shuddered. Enna then quietly spoke up.
確かに。 でもね、隊長さん。私、少し気になっていることがあるの。あなたは記憶障害を起こした上に汚染区域に入ったから幻覚を見てもおかしくないと言ったわね。でも幻覚の原因が放射線じゃないとしたら。Such
as?
以前何かで読んだことがあるのよ。確かに。
It could also cause superpowers.
それは視界混濁や視野狭窄であって見えないものが見えるなんて話は聞いたことがないわ。じゃあ、俺の幻覚の原因は？心当たりはない。ない。Enna's
words only served to confuse Watase further.
脳細胞損傷や神経障害が起きているのかもしれん。 脳や神経をやられたら、それはそれで幻覚を見ちまうんじゃないのか。そうね。でも、もう一つ気になることがあるの。隊長さん、これ見てくれる?
Enna took out her PDA. She then fiddled around with it, causing words to appear on the screen.
なんだこれ。覚えてる?前に私一人で脳科学実験室を探ってて、
浮田さんに怒られたことがあったでしょ。ああ、確かそんなことが。実はあの時、私、いけないことをしていたの。脳科学実験室のパソコンから自分の PDA にデータをコピーしていたのよ。何?なんでそんなことを?あの時点で私はすでに、この事故が普通の事故じゃないと思っていたのよ。隔壁が9時間も開かないなんて、どう考えてもおかしいじゃない。It is very weird. 何か他に原因があるんじゃないかって。確かに。でも、パソコンの中のデータは全て暗号化されていた。とりあえず、自力で複合してみたんだけど。
It's too bad. Watase remembered that Anna had indeed been fiddling around with her PDA from time to time in the last few hours for some reason. Anna then handed over the PDA to Watase. On the screen was what appeared to be sentences from a report of sorts. Case and specifications, alteration, proposal, August something, Ken Kashiwagi. On 2021, subject and attempted escape, as you already know. At the same time, this chance to reevaluate the danger of a blank. This document talks about problems hinted at by this in blank. Ev Lee, the accident, searchers S, proper S, took the chance BC with the Ensis S communicator ability. The target, their brain, shuns. Searcher, dire contact, subject, and ER0. Cool. Paradoxically, why does that word just hang out there? When just at subject and to run, something for alteration, something is war. I can't really read this. Something problem, rather, to aforementioned subject and WX. That being said, shows that T just by. I can't really. Although subject as born in labos and to let out, it's a subject deed to be careful. There were several words that caught Watase's interest. Subject blank as born in labo. It is subject T, need to be careful. But in spite of that, yeah, I don't get any of it.
So, ね、ケース N の仕様変更倫理書のようだけど、この調子で ろくに読めない文章が延々と続くわ。他のデータも全部そう。なので、手持ちのツールで何度も出てくる文字列を抜き出してみると、いくつか妙な単語が浮かび上がってきたの。本当に見てほしいのはこっちよ。ね、意味わかる？
Anna fiddled with her PDA again, this time bringing up a fully comprehensible list. Okay, string, search results, case N, area N, meltdown, subject, test subject, NBC, WX particle, particle amplifier, subject N. Okay, brain dysfunction, gene malfunction, area 0, WX powder, particle proliferation, subject Y2, gene abnormality type S, subject A. Watase felt chills run down his spine with each phrase he saw. There were multiple unknown phrases in that mix. He felt a strange yet severe sense of discomfort, but it was soon cast aside for another emotion.
危険体N、IGF2R遺伝子.
His heart shook from those phrases. He could feel a pitch-black emotion, a mix of fear, anger, and hatred, welling up from the bottom of his heart like a geyser.
隊長さん、何か見覚えが?
Ah.
They did seem familiar to him, but a second later... Uh-oh. A violent headache tore through him. It was as if his brain was refusing to let him remember. He still tried to search through his brain in spite of the pain, but no relevant memories would come to him. Really? Really? Anna let out a truly disappointed sigh.
先生は何か心当たりがあるか?
We got stopped.
そうか。でも何も思い出せない。やっぱり幻覚も幻聴も俺の脳に異常が出ているせいだと思う。記憶喪失も全て。
I don't like it. I wish we'd show her the report we found. It did seem like the cause of Watase's frequent headaches and memory problems really did lie in his brain.
だとしたら、俺自身気づいていないが。 AD を盗んだのかもしれない。自分一人だけ生き残ればいいという考えが自分の中にないとは言い切れない。Watase
suddenly began to get scared, very scared. Perhaps there was a wicked side to him that he was not aware of, one that was deciding all his actions on its own and driving everyone to their deaths. That thought was much more frightening than the prospect of his own death. But Anna spoke to Watase with a kind voice when she saw him trembling.
しっかりして。
Oh, yay!
あなたはそんな人じゃない?
Anna, I'm starting to like you more and more.
あなたは確かに疑わしいわ。監視カメラの一件にしても、記憶喪失の件にしてもね。でも私はね、それを差し引いても、あなたを信用したいと思ってるの。
You're not a bad person.
なぜだ？
だって、あなたがみんなを助けるため、必死に頑張ってくれたことは、
That is true.
間違いない真実だもの。面識もない私の生徒のために、汚染区域にまで入ってくれたことも。記憶喪失だろうと、幻覚を見ようと、そんなの、些細なことじゃない？あなたが今のあなたでいる限り、隊長さんでいる限り、私はあなたの味方よ。
Aww. Anna gazed straight at Watase. Watase couldn't bear to look her in the eye. He hung his head and answered.
ありがとう、先生。
Oh my god, that's so sweet. There was someone out there who would say they were on his side, even when he didn't trust himself. Watase was grateful for that more than anything else at the moment.
だが、どうする？森部も浮田のおっさんも。俺を心底疑っているぞ。
そうね。だから私があの二人を説得してくるわ。
まさか一人で行くつもりか。
Don't get killed。
当たり前でしょ。あなたが一緒に来たりしたら話がややこしくなるだけだわ。
それはそうかもしれないが。
すぐに戻ってくるから。ここで待ってて。
Oh, please don't get killed. And with those words, Anna left the room.Okay. Watase tried to follow her right away, only to be stopped by the image of Ukita and Jun's faces, full of hostility towards him, flashing through his mind. She's right. If I go out there, all I'll do is rile them up. Watase decided to give up on following Anna after he thought that. Okay, I'm actually going to leave this episode here because I feel like we're going to run into some really back-to-back intense consequences.And I'm gonna have to make some choices. So we'll leave that for next time. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching. Let me know if you enjoyed. I'll see you guys on the next MAMJ. Let's play.